let this be a normal field trip with a friend? No way!
Cruising on down Main Street, you're relaxed and feeling good. Next thing that you know, you'll see it.
Octopus in my neighborhood.
Surfing on the sine wave, swinging through the stars. Yeah. Take a nap at your intestine. Take your second ride back, Mars.
On the magic school bus.
Navigator nostril.
I'm on the magic school bus.
Spank a plane, turn two.
Take that.
On our magic school bus.
Rock the river of lava.
On the magic school bus.
Such fine thing to do. So strap your bones right to the seat. Come on in and don't be shy. Just to make your day complete. You might get baked into a pie.
On the magic school bus.
Step inside, it's a wilder ride. Come on.
Ride on the magic school bus.
Is it finished yet, Tim?
Stop rushing me, Keisha.
How long can it take to make a model of the sun that plays Wait Till the Sun Shines Nelly when you wind it up?
There. You think DA's gonna like it?
She'll love it. It's the perfect present for her birthday.
Too bad she's sick and had to stay home today.
Hello?
How come you guys are still at school?
It's DA. We're waiting for Miss Frizzle. She's driving us over after her teacher's meeting.
Well, hurry. I want you to see my new telescope. It's really neat.
We'll be there soon. Bye.
Where is Miss Frizzle anyway?
Huh? Oh, good afternoon, class.
Perfect timing, Miss Frizzle. Tim just finished DA's present. Take a look, Miss Frizzle.
Whoa!
I'm okay, but DA's present isn't.
What are we gonna do? It's too late to make another one.
Right here, right now, you can get the perfect gift from SSN, the Star Shopping Network.
Hey, check this out. It's one of those shows where you can call up and buy things.
And here's your host, the stellar seller himself, Horace Cope. Indeed, folks, I'm Horace Cope, bringing you the perfect gift for someone you love. A star.
A star?
That's right, the star. A star from the vast reaches of the universe. And when you buy a star, you get to name it. Seriously, folks, I've only got 3 stars left. 1, 2, and 3. For the ridiculously low price of just $7 each.
That's it.
We'll all chip in $1 and get DA her very own star.
Great idea.
Let's do it.
Wait a minute. Slow down. My grandma once bought a mop from the Home Mopping Network, and it didn't mop. So I'm not spending my money on anything I haven't checked out myself.
But Keisha...
Keisha's right, Tim. We don't have to buy a star sight unseen.
We don't?
To the bus!
But what about DA's party? Stop! Wait, I... Uh-oh. I hate when this happens.
I'll give you a hand, Arnold. We're going star
shopping. Couldn't we just go to the mall? Computer, report, please.
All systems go, Ms. Frizzle. We are leaving the Earth behind.
And here comes the moon! I mean, there goes the moon!
Wow! Are we going fast or what? We just went from planet Earth to the moon in less than a minute!
As my Aunt Andromeda always says, Ralphie, to reach the stars, you have to get way past Mars!
Gee, look at all those teeny tiny stars!
I wonder if they'll get bigger when we get closer, like the moon did.
They better. We need some way to tell them apart.
Now you're probably asking,
Horace Cope, how can you sell me a star if they all look alike?
Right? Wrong. That's the beauty of it. Look closely and you'll see lots of different kinds of stars. For instance, take this little baby. Only 2 million years old. Now believe it or not, that's really young for a star. To see it, just look in the direction of the constellation Taurus the Bull. I wouldn't steer you wrong. Ooh.
Please, who ever heard of a baby star?
To see it for yourself, you'd have to fly at a speed of 500 million miles an hour, and it would still take you about 80 years just to get there. So isn't it a lot easier to just call?
80 years?
I told my mom I'd be home by 7.
Then what are we waiting for? Baby star, here we come.
Is it just me, or do we just leave our solar system behind?
Man, we've already gone so far, we can't see any of the planets anymore.
And now our sun looks as tiny as, well, a star.
Hey, Ms. Frizzle, is our sun a star, just like all the other stars out here?
Yup. Makes you think, doesn't it? Computer, star chart, please. Ah, yes, right on course. Constellation Taurus, here we come. We should be seeing the baby star right about...
coming out of hyperdrive now.
Wow!
That baby star should be around here somewhere. But it's hard to tell with all this dust and gas.
Dust and gas? Is that what these red clouds are made of?
Stellar Nursery, straight ahead.
Dust? Gas? Swirling clouds? This is not a good place for a baby.
On the contrary, Phoebe, it's the best place for a baby star.
Oh, wow! This new telescope is really neat. You can see practically forever. Take a look, Liz. You can even see huge clouds of dust and gas way up there. Gee, I wonder what they look like up close.
That can't be our baby star. It doesn't look like what we saw on TV.
You're right, Keisha. It's a ball of gas, but not a star.
What's happening? We're being sucked towards the center.
Warning, warning. Due to a large ball of hot gas, we are out of control.
At my old school, we never got pulled into the boiling hot center for a swirling cloud of dust and gas.
I know, Phoebe. Isn't this fantastic? Nobody's ever seen what we're seeing.
Lucky nobody.
What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do? What are we gonna do?
Unless we want to end up where all that dust and gas is, we'd better use reverse.
It worked! We're safe!
Good one, Tim!
Look, there's a baby star! It's been behind us the whole time!
Oh, stop! It's too bright to look at, Ms. Frizzle.
No problem, class.
Whoa!
Poor baby star, it sure is humongous!
Well, Arnold, baby stars come in all sizes. Let's see how humongous it really is, shall we? It's actually on the small side. Only about half the size of our sun.
So, it's just a baby. I say let's call up Horace Cope and buy it.
Wait a second, Tim. This is not a happy star.
Poor thing. It looks like it's got gas.
Very good, Phoebe. All stars have gas. That's what they're made of. But this 2-million-year-old baby just hasn't settled down yet. You know, it's at that awkward age.
Come on, Keisha. Let's buy it and go to the party.
No way. I'm not spending a dime on this star. It's too young and too wild.
Keisha, what kind of star are you looking for anyway?
Well, something a bit bigger and brighter with no dust around it. And it would be nice if it had a planet or two. We need a star we can trust, like our own sun.
Okay, so you don't like the baby star. Problem. Remember, there are still 2 stars left. And this next one is sensational. A shining example of a grown-up middle-aged star. And to find it, look right here in the Big Dipper.
Seats, everyone, and buckle up. Computer, how far is it?
Approximately 100 million, million miles.
That's not all. This next star even comes with its own planets. Absolutely free.
There it is, Keisha. Just the kind of star you're looking for.
It looks okay.